everywhere because this is such a fantastic sport. You have to be able to set up those takedowns. Can't just be one dynamic anymore.
Inside of Tynanes' thigh there.
A lot of heat on that punch.
That's what he's going for, the inside of that left thigh. Vuyisile's, there it is again, the left kick. Clearly honing in on that target.
Single leg.
His takedown defense is totally
deep single here. Nice, he ran the pipe, really nice takedown. Lowen showing a very solid takedown.
Big overhand right attempted by Tynanes, didn't connect. Real Hail Mary effort that was.
Working the pass. He's going to try to put, Lowen's going to try to put Colossus on flat on his back. You see Colossus is going to use the cage here to try to get his arm back around his head and walk up, creating that space. That's what we were talking about, using that cage to your benefit. If Colossus can get his back to that cage, he can wall walk up. He's going to have those chances to keep pressure on Lowen with punches and the striking department. This really is a stylistic matchup. Every time Lowen gets Colossa down, it's going to give him the opportunity to ground and pound, wear on his opponent, tire him out. But every time he misses that opportunity, then he gets stood back up. Colossa has some heavy hands and some very dynamic striking that Lowen's going to have to deal with.
Clearly, the more Lowen can keep this on the ground, the better off he'll be. Vuyisile has been moved away from the cage. He was using his feet on the cage to try and get position.
No, slow him down. Head lever. Okay, palm press. You need your palm high. It's at the elbow high. Now it's slamming.
So we have a very vociferous stream of advice coming from Vuyisile's corner men.
It's difficult, too. You hear cornermen yelling out advice. And you know, you can see that Lowen's listening to his corner because he's doing what he said, and that just shows that he has a very good ring presence. Vuyisile is looking to work underneath the double underhooks to get back to his knees, but Lowen's doing a very good job of just keeping pressure on him, not giving him that space to create any distance and get to his knees. He's going to pass guard now. But you don't want to give your back to Lowen.
Uh-oh.
Lowen's going to try to swing around and take the cheetah's back here.
He's never tapped out, Colossa.
Hasn't been submitted in his career to this date, but that's pretty deep. That's under the chin. This could be it. This is tough. He's doing what he needs to do there. He needs to go two on one, both hands on that top hand. Just Lowen's pulling it down.
Oh, and he gets out of it. That's the aspect of his game that they say has really improved.
Choke now. That's a nice transition. This is a deep head and arm choke. That's really deep. It's a very nice transition from the rear naked choke to the head and arm. Lowen needs to just cinch that up and just hold on to it and just keep walking it in nice and tight. Just like a triangle choke that cuts off your carotid artery.
It's the defense against such moves, Jason, that they say Vuyisile's really improved upon.
Well, that was beautiful defense against the rear naked choke. I mean, that choke was in deep, too, and he defended it textbook. But this is difficult, too, because this is pretty deep. He defended that too. This is great.
It's very nice. Worked it loose. Well done. And he's turned it around. And gets back on his feet. What an exhibition that was from the two of them.
He's going like a cobra, doesn't he, Colossa?
Nice double leg.
Great takedown. Emphatic there by Tynanes. Elbow to the head from Colossa.
You see Colossa's trying to post and put pressure onto Lowen's face there with the hand and then slice that elbow across, trying to open him up a little bit. Guys like Kenny Florian were very, very good at that.
Tynanes just had a feel of his own face there to see if he was cut, and he is. And he knew it straight away. While they were down there, he dabbed at his forehead, took a look to see if there was blood on his hand. And it wasn't long before It became evident on his face. That's why the fight is stopped.
It doesn't look like a big cut, so I don't think that this is going to be an issue with the fight moving forward, but obviously safety is always a priority, so just want to check it out.
One of the issues is it's high on his head and it's streaming into the eye, which clearly causes a visibility problem. And that's what a lot of these concerns are. It's way up there in the hairline, but it's where the blood falls.
Well, they'll probably put a little adrenaline or some Vaseline on that to stop it up. Shouldn't be too bad. Cuts in the hairline aren't as bad as right over the eye. It's further away is a little bit better.
These cuts are administered by ONE FC officials, not the fighter's own corner men.
There's just a couple of really great seconds of action in that first round. That takedown was powerful. You see right here, Colossa setting up those strikes, and as soon as he opened up, it was a beautiful double leg. Turned the corner, flared the legs out. Huge double.
He also has a little nick underneath the right eye. I think you could see it there. A little bit of treatment going to it. That's not so much of a problem. Now, they've arrested the flow of that blood for now. Vuyisile Colossa will be working on it. You can bet on that.
Vuyisile's got a lightning fast jab. He's really comfortable on his feet, by the way.
Yeah, he is light on his feet, isn't he? But so strong, Tynanes. Colossa went clattering into the cage door there. They well have really hurt his heel.
That was the first takedown attempt that Colossa was able to stuff. It builds your confidence a little bit when you're stopping those takedowns, and also it takes a little bit out of the gas tank. Lowen missing those takedowns is very, very tiring. Nice inside leg kick again.
Still working the inside of that left leg, and there are welts forming now. There it is again, and a good right hand from Colossa. Right on that cut, up there in the hairline. His momentum took him to the knees. He goes for the inside thigh again. All out attack from Vuyisile.
Well, that's a really smart move if you're fighting a wrestler, just beating up the legs like that, because you're kicking the head, you open up that takedown a little more, but by taking out the legs, that's it. That dynamic shift when you lower your body weight to shoot, it makes it much more difficult for your opponent to get in nice and deep, and also it's gonna slow him down on those shots.
Clearly is the game plan. Tynanes looks so strong in the upper body. Really needs to get back to grips with his opponent if he's going to arrest this flow in the second round from the South African.
Colossus hit almost every one of those leg kicks right now.
Oh, and a flying knee followed up by punches. Tynanes hurt for a moment there.
Tynanes looks like he's starting to see the effects of some of those leg kicks. A couple of hematomas opening up on both the left and the right thigh of Lowen.
It's like a lightning strike, isn't it? The sound of that slap on the inside of his thigh. There it is again.
Sort of, but lightning doesn't hit the same spot twice, and I think we've seen Colossa hit the same spot 17 times.
Together they come again, a super right uppercut to the chest from Colossa. The jab is a strong one. They're exchanging punches. Oh, Colossa takes a kick that pushes him off balance.
Yeah, that front teep was nice by Lowen. Lowen can't just stay square in front of Colossa. He's going to have to move side to side.
Yeah.
He's getting that range just exploited by Colossa.
Just took a belter on the chin. Tynanes. He's looking a little tight. Another good right hand from Vuyisile. A good overhand right encounter there from Tynanes. But he's not throwing punches in bunches like the South African is. Needs to take this to the ground, does the American.
This reminds me like Marco Huas, Paul Barlins back in the day when there's 150,000 leg kicks.
Colossa, head down, chin tucked in. Classic boxer stance. Bit of an unorthodox straight right there, almost like a southpaw's jab. Caught his opponent there with a short right. Tynanes keeps coming in though.
Lowen hasn't really had an answer for those kicks. It looks like he might just be kind of waiting for his time. Oh, he checked one as I said that. That front left thigh is really swollen up now.
Final 20 seconds and Tynanes seems to have lost his way a little bit in this round.
The cheetah's just stalking his prey.
Final 10 seconds, the takedown comes. Not much will be achieved in this round from that. Too simple. Welts under both eyes. There he is, feeling them. If you just look at the faces of the two men, it would appear to be clear who's winning. First round. This fight brought to you by Show Company, and the takedown again from Tynanes, picking up where he left in the first round.
Like you said, the main difference is that we don't score takedowns like all the other MMA organizations. They're beautiful and they're great, but at the end of the day, we need to see damage. So those takedowns may not necessarily win it. He's looking for an armbar attempt there. Got to be careful, because if Colossus gets back up, nice hit throw.
Tremendous noise in the Putra Stadium, Kuala Lumpur. Appreciating the skills of both fighters. Very different though they are.
It's very, very frustrating too when you have a guy that you're taking him down and you get in these positions where you're close to getting a submission and you're not able to close the deal. It's fatiguing both mentally and physically because you're putting all your effort into feeling like that submission is right there. So you're squeezing and you're putting the pressure on it. And then when you don't get it, it's very frustrating.
I think the cut on Tynanes' forehead may have taken a turn for the worse in this close quarter action. A lot of blood leaking onto the canvas there. Quite often the act of the rubbing of the head on the body and face means that the cut can be aggravated. If you look at Vuyisile's chest, it's bathed in his opponent's blood.
And that's just another factor too. When you have all that blood, it acts as a lubricant. It makes it much harder to hold your opponent down. And if there's one thing that Colossus has been good at, it's been scrambling whenever Lowen gives him any space. He's doing exactly what he needs to do. You see the cheetah's keeping that left arm. He was under the far armpit of Lowen. That gives him the inside position to kind of shoot up and get to his knees when he needs to.
This third round taking the same sort of shape that the first round took. The second was so different. And if Tynanes can maintain this kind of control, he may just give him the edge.
It's tough to call too, because from a damage point of view, do you look at the fact that that cut was open up on Lowen and say that's more damage? Do you say, hey, you know what, he put 500 shots right down the pipe on the ground. I feel like that was more damaging. So,
very true, yeah.
I'm glad I'm not a judge in these situations.
Final 2.5 minutes then. Can Colossa bring this one back up to their feet? They'll give it all he can, but Tynanes will push down for all his worth. Very slippery now, sweat and blood.
Lowen did a really good job of getting hip control there. Colossa had some distance, started pushing the face, had his back against the cage. Lowen recognized that, went down, grabbed his hips, pulled him out from under him, trying to keep his back flat. If Lowen can keep if Tynanes can keep Colossus' hips flat down.
Oh, the up kick! The up kick from Colossa, bringing the crowd to their feet here.
Well, you know, he ate an up kick there, but he actually traded the up kick for better positioning. Being cross-eyed is much more dominant, and I think that he's gonna try to work into mount here. Can't hold onto the fence.
Yes, you can't do that. He wasn't warned about it.
Now, he can wall walk here. If Colossus starts working his feet up the cage, it's going to give him that explosion, that room to just kind of get out of that situation and get back to his feet.
Exactly what he's doing. He's locking those toes in on the cage.
And this is going to be an interesting position.
How about this?
Lowen needs to fight and get to his knees. Lowen's going to be able to take Colossus back here. Just like that.
Oh, well
called. Sweat factor. Very difficult to hold on.
With a minute left, just over, in this final round.
Now, unlike the first round, if Colossa here stands up, it may be able to shake him off. But, oh, Tynanes is in on that rear naked choke again. That's deep. That is nice and deep. This could be the first time that the cheetah gets submitted. So difficult.
So slippery, really.
30 seconds.
I don't think he'll manage to make it count.
Wait, it's right there.
Oh, he has tapped out. Oh, what a surprise. I really didn't think we'd see Vuyisile do that. With 30 seconds left of the contest, it just became too deep. He couldn't endure it any longer. And Lowen Tynanes has launched himself into the 1FC scene. Having beaten one of 1FC's superstars in Edward Folayong, he's now defeated Vuyisile Colossa.
That was a lot of action back and forth. This was a spectacular fight. It was an up kick, he just ate right there, but he was able to transfer right into cross side. And that rear naked choke, as deep as it gets.
For your winner, by way of submission, via rear naked choke, from the red corner, Lowen Tynanes!